Virginia, I was thinking about the old schoolhouse and life there at Annetta, and wrote a little bit of something that I'll share with you now. Mama's wood stove. Mama's wood stove stood just inside the kitchen door of the stone schoolhouse. It was a two-tone beauty of seafoam green and cream with home comfort emblazoned across the oven door. The black cast iron cook surface was of an even ebony color, except where the metal got hottest, right above the firebox. There it sported shades of gray and slate and white oxidation. There were four removable burners where you could expose the pot to direct flame or lift and feed wood into the firebox. Mama would slide your pans across the stove to find just the right temperature for the task at hand. She would execute a ballet there before the stove, dipping to check the oven, pirouetting with a dishcloth in hand to pick up a piece of firewood or lift the lid on a seething pot of beans. Clothed in a long dress and checkered apron with her long dark hair caught up in a messy bun. A two-door warming shelf overhung the cook surface. You could place bread dough in that to rise slowly on a cold winter's day, or pre-warm socks or mittens. A once white radio sat in the kitchen window where it got the best reception. If Daddy was not in the kitchen, it was tuned to the preachers. Brother Ray T. Pedigo missions to Japan, asking you that you send a dollar today to Box 54, Dalhart, Texas, to help save the heathens. I remember her telling me excitedly about a new song she had heard, How Great Thou Art. If the religious programs were on when Daddy entered, he would often launch into an angry rant about the doctors and the lawyers and the preachers and how they were ruining the country. Mama boiled great vats of pinto beans, fried potatoes, and cornbread baked in a cast iron skillet, or my favorite, her biscuits. They were not flaky confections to melt in the mouth, but tough, durable creations that could be stuffed with fried potatoes for a lunch or slathered in fresh churned butter and blessed with a spoon of wild plum jam. They were the perfect companion of the milk gravy made with bacon grease. Sigh. I hope you're well, Virginia. Love you.